Alright, welcome back everybody. We are playing ActRaiser, and we are heading to Marhana, which would be the fifth land stage level, whatever you want to call it, in the game. So Marhana is actually kind of like the swamp jungle type land, and honestly, I think this is maybe the most challenging level for me. So this boss this first boss actually, I don't even think the second boss really gives me that much of a problem, but the first boss is actually a little bit tough. So if I die, I would expect to do it here. So they are reusing the music here again, but obviously it's a very different level. So jungle, nice background, a lot of different colors, flowers, a whole bunch of stuff. Some creative enemies here, like pygmies or something like that. Moving statues, you know? So that's one of the fun things about ActRaiser 2. As you see, this guy somehow has, like, range behind him. So yeah, I don't really know exactly what the story is on this, but definitely not really challenging. Ugh, except this guy. Alright, come on. So if I was trying harder, I would actually try to time out the guy's attack right there. So I was hitting the arrow. Okay, I think here's the boss, so I could hit him and the arrow at the same time. Alright, so this is actually kind of challenging. So it's going to spit out this thing, and what you want to do is head over here so that the tentacle gets you, and then you can come and take a few shots at the bad guy before the tentacle comes out and gets you. So you got the tentacle and you got that thing. Alright, not so hot. So mostly this thing will harass you, and it sucks. So you wanna, like, get your shots in. Ah, boy. Okay, that was best case scenario. Okay, I think that was even worse. Okay. Maybe the, flame thing would be best. Alright, and if you time it right, you'll just kind of keep that tentacle guessing, which is what you want to do, because that thing will just make your life miserable. So I think we're good. Yeah. So I don't know, there's probably some kind of much easier way to do it, because it seems like everything in this game is relatively easy, but that one actually took a little bit of skill. So I think we get our third magic here, which is the magic aura. I want to say there's four, but I'm not quite sure. Let me guess. Oh, it's unexpected. Palm trees. Would you destroy some of the palm trees? So it's nice. I mean, they give like kind of a different type of terrain. You have, you know, your tree obstacles, but it's also got that marsh stuff going. Like, blood pool, I want to say. And all this stuff is, yeah, again, just so much easier now that we have pretty much like limitless like SP. Oh, and so here we go. You know, they actually have a grain, and as soon as you see one of those things, you wanna hit it with wheat so that every other one that they create from here on out will be wheat. Nice little bird-shaped island, kind of like the, I don't know what you call it. Kind of landmark on, Cassandra's map. Alright, one down. Yep, some arrows, so Strength of the Angel, unexpected. West to here. Is there any way to make the channel and the island into a part of our continent? Watch me. So it's kind of cool how they did that. I mean, you know, without having a situation like that, Earthquake wouldn't really be necessary, but, you know, it's like every miracle has some kind of purpose in the game, even though you can also use them to, you know, just do multiple things. Temple has suddenly appeared in Marhana. Built to worship you, but I sense something's wrong. It's the only building the monsters have not tried to destroy. Yeah. Tell me something that isn't terrible that's happened. Okay, cool. I think you can use the compass here to get the magical aura. But we're not gonna. Later on, they're gonna, you know, sail over to this island and explore it, and then say, oh, something, you need to destroy a tree, but already know that's coming, so... Eternal Master, I believe the shrine may be the cause of this change of heart. I just thought you should know. Actually, what I'm gonna do is kill the blue dragons because they're more annoying. So I wanna say these houses are different too, the level 2. Sweet. Marhana houses. Little like thatch huts or something. Pretty cool. Strange statue, it's probably a bomb. See, and just like Eidos, the Marhana map is just really small. I guess it could be bigger if it didn't have these trees. These trees you can't get rid of with lightning. They're just kind of there for good. But you can see, like, you know, the amount of land you have to work with is just a lot less. Which is not bad, I mean, it just makes these sim parts go faster. Temple's nice. Got kind of like a like Angkor Wat type kind of feel to it, something like that. No one seems to be here. Hearts drawn away by the evil powers. You must enter the shrine and fight to save your people. So I think... Okay, Marhana is normal. Let's just earthquake it. Boom, dead. Okay, I'm kind of surprised. I figured, after, you know, stating that everybody's gone, like, I figured they'd just kill the population growth, but actually, 32, 37, so about 450, maybe? So it's kind of funny that, you know, Marhana's level 3 housing is like a lot of people's level 2 housing. Them everywhere. Yeah, I have a feeling that we're not gonna get to 500 before we have to fight the boss. Okay. So I'm actually just going to... Well, let's see what goodies I have. Oh, I can't even take an offering? Come on. Alright, well, we're heading back to the Sky Palace then. Alright, so the boss is, kind of like, oh, it's the Indian god with eight arms. I don't know, I can't think of the name right now, but that's what we're fighting. Yes, they are. Alright, I think we got a life, which is cool. Okay, I think there is something across the way, but whatever. That's cool. Grim Reaper. Okay, cool. Ah. Oh, this level's annoying. Oh man. Oh, okay. That's cool. I'll take it. I would like an apple. See? There's just that weird thing about, like, his ability to hit behind him. His crazy range too. I could probably hit that guy. Maybe not. Alright. Okay. Kind of a cool little puzzle. Ugh. Ugh. You can only be so careless. But we got another one up. So it doesn't really even matter. I know that there's apples in this level, and I'm just missing, like, all of them. Those guys are just timing. The boss, yeah, I see. right, this is definitely the right magic. So there's platforms that fall and you have to climb up on them. Let me see if I can get one to drop. She hits the... It hits the ground. Okay, there you go. Then you have to climb up and hit, and that's kind of what you'd normally do, but if you have magic, just take it down super easy. Look at the background. How much time that must have taken. That's crazy. Really nicely done. Was a difficult task for us. No matter how many homes we seemed to build, monsters came and destroyed them. In the midst of all of our troubles, a man of eloquence appeared. Should have sat by becoming the monster's followers. Trouble and hardship would be eliminated from lives. Okay, so... And you guys all fell for it. I realize how susceptible human beings are, all of us. Learned a very important lesson from this experience. Never betray you again. We can now carry on without your help. Yeah, because I will earthquake you all into the ground. So we'll stick around and wait till they max out, and they're gonna give us the herbs, and they're gonna give us the power of the aura or whatever. Here we go. So we already have the herbs. I'll just leave all that other stuff. It's funny the way Marhana works out. I think all this stuff happens like so quickly that most of the sim actually takes place after you've kind of beaten the level. Or maybe it's just the way we played it. Just killing the monsters so quickly. Nothing happened. Yeah, eventually these guys are gonna start sailing. So we'll wait till they do that. I'm pretty sure we'll get another level out of this place anyways. I guess the houses are a little bit different. I think the level 2 wooden houses don't have all this like a white trim on them. Whatever that is. Angel butt. There we go, 22. Comes 4100. So I think the last couple ones are kind of spread out a little bit. So I think they're starting to run out of places to build. I wonder if that's it. Nope. I don't think I've ever played this game out of order. I don't think it'll stop you. But if you ever want to find the order, you can just literally look at the list of cities. Figure this out on their own, but I feel like I got stuck with the compass the last time I played this. Like, I didn't use it. Alright, we'll let it go one more time. So you'll literally see this boat just go over here, and then it has to come back, and I don't know why they needed to do that, but... We have found a scroll while deep sea fishing. We present it to you as an offering. Please accept it. Source of magic. So I think we're at like 7 or 8 or something. Why does it go so slow? Of course, he's like taking the long way around. I really want to say this is a thing where they talk about exploring this island. Maybe they need to do this whole deep sea fishing. Thank you. Alright, let's do this. Let's go to Cassandora and give him the herbs. And then maybe maybe by the time we're done with this, they'll have the magic aura. I don't think I'm gonna need it. Ancient tablet under the rock. Oh, okay, there we go. Okay, so you get the tablet. My mistake. Well, at least we got a source of magic. See, I guess the game drags a little bit right here, because you have to come back to Cassandora, have them, you know, finish, you know, building their houses and all that stuff, and then go back to Marhana and have them fish for the, or go to the island and get the, magical aura. Always in the upper left, a dude and his donkey, or dog. Is it a dog? I don't know. Horse? Alright, so they're maxed out. Okay, cool. So, let's head back to Marhana. Oh, shoot. We need to get the tablet. Change the music, like, once the plague got taken care of. Alright, here we go. Investigate the birch, and then now we gotta wait, so this kinda sucks. Oh yeah, because the people actually have to walk from the temple to the boat. Ah, take your time, guys. Take your time. Sail back. to walk back to the temple. Alright, cool. So this is how we get the magical aura. So that, I think, is the third spell. I'm not sure. I feel like there's a fourth, but there may only be three. Alright, so we're gonna leave the other stuff. So that is Marhana, and I think we're done with all the backtracking, so I'm gonna take a quick break, and then we'll do North Wall. So I'll see you guys in a bit.